walk last year as a senior director, and she will be walking this year, crossing the stage as an executive director. She's been with the company 6.5 years. I'm sure you guys have seen her at the top of many different categories in the company. She's a joy to work with, a joy to be around. She's absolutely amazing, a true leader within this organization. Founders Awards, Excellence Awards, all those things you name, she's achieved it. So I give you Ms. Crystal Jackson.
First. adding in positive affirmations, learning to train our brain to replace those negative thoughts. The base of my success has been as a result of personal growth, failing, learning from it, picking myself up, and making a decision to not stay there and wallow in it, but decide to fail forward. Decide. Have you ever thought about the word decide? To come to a resolution in the mind as a result of consideration. Let's be honest, we can hem-haw around and ride the fence till we are blue in the face. But when we decide to make a change, that's when we see action. And that's exactly what I did that night. I heard the buffalo versus the cow call. I decided to make a change, and change immediately, starting with a $1,000 party that night and a new team member. Because it all starts with decision, followed with a mindset change and belief. As we went into the fall of 2015, those changes truly took effect. I focused on going back to what I enjoyed most about Pampered Chef. Fun! What's that fun? Isn't that why we're all here? And all the other benefits. I realized if I wasn't having fun, how on earth was I going to attract anyone else to join me in this journey? I started by focusing on our live team meetings, since that was before the big virtual party boom hit our team. It was still live. We started holding recipe night and team meetings together, which included the recognition. And we found that by having them all in one night versus separate, it attracted more team members and guests to attend. We focused on cooking show basics. We'd spotlight different leaders to do their intros, their portions of their parties. Have team members sign up for different ingredients to bring. That way they felt a part of it, and if they weren't there, then they were going to truly be missed. I gave them jobs like door greeter, in charge of icebreakers, on-time drawings, speaking on certain topics they're having success in. And guys, the meetings totally changed. People love coming each month, having fun and seeing their friends. And our team meetings grew from just a handful of people to over 25 plus over the next 6 months. The secondary part was small groups. I personally invited 3 to 5 people to be in my local area small group program. And this is something about just being invited to an exclusive training group. If you've ever been invited, you know how special you feel and how it makes you just kind of step up your efforts a notch than maybe before. Starting out, I really didn't have a lot of people who were looking for directorship, so I partnered with those who just wanted more in their business. And I was so excited because they not only grew personally and in their businesses, but in their friendships with each other, and then therefore their leadership roles, both in our recipe nights and in our team Facebook page as well. And it brought me back to not only the fun of Pampered Chef, but the connection and how much each of us, whether we know it or not, are really looking for those connections with each other. So why on earth did I tell you about the climate of the team? And how does that relate to, you know, building directors and building your team to the next level? So the fall of 2015 is when we worked on culture. This set the groundwork for what was to come with the boom of 2016 and continuing now. And in February of 16, I was asked to be in lead, but this time, I was really excited. I was really excited and mentally ready to stretch, which was a change from the mindset that I had felt the previous year. I'd have 2 recruits each month, no matter what, so from February to June, that's exactly what I did. I'd been a fairly consistent recruiter before then, so it didn't really scare me, but I was on a different mindset this time. And when the team saw the joy and the passion in which I was sharing the business, they started to realize, okay, I think I can have confidence to do this myself. So we promoted a director in March, then our first fast track in April, another director in May, 3 in August, 1 in September, and another in October as we promoted to executive on November 1st. So our culture for recruiting is affected by the attitude that we share what we love about Pampered Chef. We focus on the blessing that this business can be for others and how others can be benefited in just, okay, so what am I going to get when you join my team? Do you think others would love what you love about Pampered Chef? Then share that with them. It's a blessing to share with others. The numbers are constantly in front of my team, and my team always knows what our goals are and where we are at. And I truly believe that's how we keep the culture going past that initial promotion. Last year, you know, something that we did was freezer paper. Some of you may have done freezer paper where you share your recruiting goal and you add the names to it every time somebody joins your team. I would hang it up at live meetings and also take pictures of it and put it up on the Facebook page.
But also, in addition to that, this year, you know, or I'm sorry, we also shared our team vision board on our team structure, had the houses on it, and all of the expectations of how it works to be able to get your own house, and it was open and ready for their picture to be on it. So when someone would have their first recruit join, this is something that I absolutely love that our team would do, is they would get a little Woodstock character, and we would put their Woodstock on the board, put their name on it, and a little sticky dot with their first recruit's name on it. So they could basically watch their team grow and see them getting closer and closer to the house on the board. This year I decided to make our vision board follow along more with our Making Waves team name, and because I see other people being so creative, so now instead of a Woodstock, they get a fish. And instead of a house, they're getting a sea creature. And so it's just something fun to kind of change it up. No more black board, it's now a blue board to be like the ocean. So have fun with it, because when you're having fun, then they're having fun as well. And every month I post our organizational sales goal and our recruiting numbers for the month. I've turned into a Canva addict. I'm on there all the time. But I remind them that our one-year goal is 250 people this year, so that they know that we want to add at least 21 people a month. So posting a graphic also when the director teams go green, so that I can congratulate them and also tag anybody that has already had sales to help them get there. Team members love to be tagged on the Facebook page. And now with the majority of our team being virtual, I actually use a picture online to update when team members join. Because frankly, I had the freezer paper hanging at the top of my ceiling and it was all the way around the floor, so we had to find a new way to be able to do that. And so now, since our team name is Making Waves, each person gets their name on a little wave as they join the team, and it continues to grow. So I would say that changing the team's culture is base for changing everything that you want in your business. Once you change your culture, the next important component is connection. Just like Ellington talked about, is connecting with people and helping them as they're ready to promote to the next level, sustain that desire throughout the month. It's all about that connection with them. Much of our time spent glued to those working towards directorship includes constant encouragement and belief in their ability to promote. It requires you to connect on a deeper level with your consultants than maybe you ever have before. Literally sticking to them like glue. We're talking every single day. Be connected to them constantly. Help them track their numbers. Send them screenshots of their team sales. Send quick encouraging notes like, I believe in you. We've got this together. Just, you never know what that quick little message is going to mean to someone that you thought of them and you took the time to send that. And another form of connection that I absolutely am loving is through connecting with the teams. We have faster and stronger growth when I connect with the teams, looking for them to promote as a director team versus just a director. Meaning, you know, when someone has one or two recruits, why not all of y'all work towards it together? We set up Facebook messaging groups, and all of the team members are in there together, and they are excited. And it really helps, you know, when you're talking about, okay, so when you're going to promote, you need five people, and they all need to be active. But cool news, did you know? They don't all have to be from you. And that really helps that upcoming director. Like, really? I didn't know that. Even if you told them that before, they may still not know that. We have to hear those things more than once, remember? So it's really important for us to work not only with that upcoming director, but also the indirect recruits, because it just leads to a faster promotion and a stronger, stable team once they've actually promoted. And so I love the Facebook groups, because that's where you can really spend some time getting to know other people in the downline and building those relationships that you may not have had a chance to build otherwise. You can include an incentive if you want to, or just use it as an opportunity to congratulate them, provide sales updates, and just what's going on and encourage them along the way. But our connections are so important. We can reach the goal, and we will do it together. And that's something that I've really learned is, we will do it together. Not you're going to do it, but we will do it together, continuing letting them know we are linked arm in arm, and we're going to be doing this together. And, you know, we do it every day because we all know that negative Nancy, aka our brain, is not our friend. And our brain will believe what it is told. Hardly ever does it send us positive feedback or encouraging thoughts on its own. And we have the incredible privilege each day to to remind them of how amazing they are. And I really hope that you understand the true blessing that is that we have that opportunity to pass that on to someone else, to pour your knowledge into someone else and help them succeed just as you have succeeded in your own business. Because at the end of the day, passion, there's that word again, passion and excitement are contagious and helps them want to push forward and succeed even more. Thank you.